This is East Leake Quarry. It's probably not an obvious place to come and do a spot of bird watching. However, in the last few weeks, over 10,000 people have come here to do just that. And they've come hoping to get a glimpse of an exotic and very colourful bird that's chosen this quarry to nest in. And it is the bee eater.
Widespread in warmer southern climes, European bee eaters are rare visitors to the UK. But in the last few years, they've been spotted more and more, to the delight of eager twitchers.
Have you seen them yet?
No, I haven't.
And have you seen anything yet?
Not yet, no. It's a bit early yet, but...
Have you ever seen bee eaters before?
Abroad, not in the UK.
Are you excited?
Yeah, as excited as everyone else.
Excited and patient, 4 hours and still no sign.
We think there'll be a loud cry go up when something appears.
Oh, so is that your technique? You stand back?
Yes, and wait for
everyone else to do the hard work.
Exactly.
And then rush forward. No, I like that. I'm going to follow you girls.
There's a bee eater on the wires over there. It's miles away, but it's on that wire.
Oh, yeah, I just saw it fly, actually, yeah. You can just about make out the colour. Well, hopefully we'll see it closer, but that is the first time that most of us have seen a bee eater in the UK, I think. Let's have a round of applause.
But there's not just one bee eater here, there's seven. A vibrant group that's been mesmerising RSPB's Mark Thomas since they arrived.
Mark, you've spotted them, I hear.
Yeah, they just perched down here, just on the water level.
Oh,
perched on a branch.
Look at that.
They're amazing.
Oh, they're such stunning birds. Probably bigger than people expect.
Yeah, they're kind of starling size, but like a longer tail.
Oh, that flash of yellow. The thing is, with the water in the background, I mean, we could be in Africa, couldn't we? Or maybe not. It'd be a bit warmer.
Oh, it's got to be the one on the right. It's going to land back down with the perch, with the bee. Oh, yep, banging the bee.
Oh, look at that. So that's what they do then. They catch the bee, they come back on their perch and they thrash the sting out of it.
Yep.
I mean, you must be just so chuffed that you've got bee eaters here.
It's phenomenal. It's absolutely phenomenal. We've got three nests now and we've got chicks in the nests.
There's obviously been a huge amount of excitement around these birds.
Very, very much so. I mean, they are the most colourful birds. They're the rainbow bird, and it's the kind of thing, if you gave a three-year-old some crayons and said, draw an imaginary bird, they'd come up with something like a bee eater. You know, yellows and turquoises and browns.
It's worth getting out of bed for, isn't it?
They are brilliant.
Was it you that discovered them?
No, it was a local bird watcher. He came to this quarry, it's somewhere where he comes occasionally, and just happened across a flock of seven bee eaters. You know,
day for him.
The stuff of dreams. I mean, I'd love to find seven bee eaters.
It's really exciting to have them here, but I guess the question is, why are they here? Not only in the UK, but why have they chosen this quarry?
In recent years, greater numbers have been arriving in the UK, and we think it's probably climate change linked. So we've had now, this is the fifth breeding attempt in the last 10 years, and this is the largest group of birds we've had in one go.
So there are seven of them. Obviously they've paired up. What does the extra one do?
We've got a helper, and bee eaters are quite unique in that they often travel with a helper bird, and that is often a young bird from the previous year. And its duty is to basically service the three nests with food.
And is it always just one, or are there sometimes quite a few? They can be
several, but they are related. They're thought to be the offspring of one of the pairs from the previous year.
So what do you think the chances are of bee eaters making the UK their home in the future?
It is highly likely these birds could colonise the UK.
Gosh, how exciting will that be?
Yeah, the rainbow bird in Britain, it doesn't really fit, but hey, they are great birds to see.
More than great. Fantastic, stunning bird to see. Have you seen them in the UK, Chris?
I have, yeah. I saw one many years ago on a telephone wire in South Wales in the 1970s, yeah. And again, more recently, they are bred on the Isle of Wight.
Did they?
Close to home.
Well, it, very sad, though, that they didn't actually have a successful rearing in the end. And people have speculated why that would be. Some people think it's because of this. Now, this is where they're nesting. You can see one of the bee eaters go in. Look what follows it. A kestrel pokes its head in the hole of the nest and flies off. Would the kestrel be a threat to the bee eater? Well, first of all, I think we've got to think about how big the bee eater is. Let's have a look at how big it is compared to another bird, the great spotted woodpecker. You can see it's a similar size. So it's about the size of a starling, I guess. So what do you reckon, Chris? I mean, would a kestrel take a bee eater?
It certainly would, yeah.
Would it?
Well, do you know how much a bee eater weighs?
Well, I would guess, I don't know.
8 2-pence pieces.
How many grams is that?
It's
then?
About 50 grams.
50 grams?
Yeah, and starlings are about 75 grams. And kestrels feed on starlings quite frequently, particularly young starlings at the end of the summer. Blackbirds, 100 grams. A robust kestrel will take a blackbird too. So I've got to say, a bee eater's an actually quite an easy meal for a kestrel.
So it certainly could have been bothering the bee eaters, but they actually think, the RSPB thinks, that there just wasn't enough food around. And if I tell you that when they're rearing their young, they have to catch about 225 flying insects every day. I mean, that's obviously bees, dragonflies, butterflies, wasps, that sort of thing. There just wasn't enough feed around. There wasn't enough insects. So sadly, they didn't make it this year. But they have nested 8 times since the 1920s, and they've successfully reared young 4 times. But what's interesting is the last couple of times was 2014, 2015. So it's getting more regular. So I guess the question is, how regular does it have to be before they colonise the UK?
Yeah, when we're seeing these birds, which are responding to climate change, we're having milder winters and warmer, wetter summers. What we see is a trend like this. We've got this information from the Rare Breeding Birds panel. Now, this is a bird here called the Great White Egret, and this is data from 1990. And this indicates the number of summering Great White Egrets in the UK. And you see it comes up to here when you get your first breeding in 2012. And what seems to happen is that these birds need to increase their summering population up to the point, I suppose, where they can find mates. Perhaps if they're returning to a site, it's a site they know which is suitable to breed. And then they reach a sort of a threshold where they start to breed. And I have to say, the reason that this is escalated all the way up here is that great white egrets are now breeding every year and producing young in this country, which are presumably staying to breed. And that's what we predict is going to happen with the bee eaters. Since 2000, I think they've been here 6 times, is it? I think trying to breed 6 times since 2000. So this will continue, and I reckon by the another 10 years' time, they'll be regular breeders.
It'd be fantastic to have them here. Mm. Beautiful birds, definitely, as I said, worth getting out of bed for.
Certainly is. Certainly is.